Good evening. Goeienaand. Moweni. Dumelang. Kia ora. Yes, jy het 'n antwoord vir alles. Goeiemiddag. Good man, I just want to welcome everybody to the 6th Eastern Cape Mighty Men Conference. Well done. Well done. Well done. Do me a big favor, just tell your neighbor, welcome. And that one behind you, just tell him, you should have been here last year. I want to thank the guys there at the back. They are sorting out the sound and they're making sure that we can be together, although we are all over. So thank you. Gentlemen, it is good to have you here with us. It's an amazing 3 days ahead of us. If you came here with some concerns, you will hear the answer. It has never changed. His name is Jesus. He is the way. He is the truth. Man, there's just no way to the Father but by Him. No way. So welcome. This is the place to be. Invite your friends. Tell them, come, pack your bags. Man, we've got a lineup of speakers for you that's going to be amazing. Dewald, I don't think we have to play that video again. I think you played it 3 times. I think the rules is short. But listen, there's a couple of things I want to ask you. Number one, please, this is the habitat of snakes, frogs, en hy goed wat jy so byt, daai klein goedjies, vlooie. Don't fight with them, resist them and they must flee. All right. Also, please, if there's a fence, it's there for a reason, don't climb through it. And if the gate is closed, that's there for a purpose as well. So please, gentlemen, it's so nice not to say, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, please stay out where you shouldn't be. We just want to thank Andre and the team for allowing us to be here. I also want to thank the wonderful team of Jeffreys Bay, Gene and his team. I want to thank them for allowing us. So can we just put our hands together for these guys and say thank you. But I want to introduce a couple of people to you. Are you ready? Okay, let me get you awake first. Amen! I don't know, Gene. Maybe they want your voice. I don't know. Amen! 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 Hallelujah! Can I please ask, firstly, on the stage with me, somebody that needs no introduction. It's my good friend and awesome brother, Eugene Genis. Can we say hello to him? Gina is going to be our brother that's going to be on Sunday. Then Saturday evening, morning. Say hello to our brother. Then the other one, Mr. Douglas. Come on, Martin. Next, somebody that knows, needs no introduction. Zane. Bios. Welcome, brother, fathers and sons, and then Okay Furie. I say it's okay om okay genoem te word. Okay Furie. Brothers, can we please stretch our hands to these brothers, and let's just pray together. Father God, I just want to thank you for this start of a conference where from Wednesday already, Father God, your presence has been felt tangibly. Father, we've seen, yeah, over the last couple of days, life's changed already. Because God, you are in the heart business. You are setting people free, Father. You are renewing hearts, Lord. And I thank you for that, Lord. And Father, yes, your servants. Men of God that loves you, Lord. I can vouch for every single one of them, Lord. And they are going to give their all over this weekend. And I pray, Father God, that you will bless each one of them. I thank you, Lord God, for their obedience and their readiness to be here and to do what you want them to do. Lord, I pray for every single man here. I pray for an open heart. I pray for a heart that's ready to receive what God is going to try to say to us. And let it fall into fertile ground. And that will carry fruit, good fruit, that we can take to our families. Because as we have declared it over and over again, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. So Father, let thy will be done. Let your kingdom come. And we declare you as our God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. We pray this in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen and amen.
Amen. Let's try again, guys. Amen. Better. One more time. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thanks, Gina. I'll beat him. Don't worry. I'll get there. It is time for me also to introduce to you our worship team for the next 3 days. May I ask Midpoint Worship to please join us? Can we say hello to them? I can tell you on the drums, we've got Ardu Black. On bass, we've got nobody else than Jason Norville. And he's got the voice as well. Oh, Meneer Kotze. Ian Kotze is here. Stephen Kapp, he's going to give the electrics. And then, of course, we've got JP Greiling. Brothers, open your hearts. And may God bless you. And enjoy the worship.
Amen, amen, amen. There you are, let's stand up. And I know we've already prayed. We're going to pray again. We're just going to surrender our hearts to the King so that he can come and do his work tonight in our hearts. Father, we come to you and we pray, Holy Spirit, that you will come and take captive our minds, take captive our hearts, our eyes and our ears, all our senses, Lord. We want to surrender it to you. And pray, Father, come and do exactly what you want to do. We want to see more of you. More of you. Empty us of this world, Lord, and fill us with yourself, Lord. More of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Thank you that you have saved us, Lord. Thank you that you have set us free. And that we can come tonight and boldly approach the throne of grace. And sing and bring glory and honor to your name. Amen, amen, amen. Let's give a hand to our Lord. He is so worthy. You are the Word at the beginning. One with God, the Lord Most High. Hidden glory in creation. Now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. Didn't want heaven without. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. Our sin was great, your love was greater. Thank you, Lord. What could separate us? Now let's sing it together. What a wonderful name. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a wonderful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is, the name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is, the name of could not hold you, fail to Lord, come and open up our eyes tonight. We want to surrender our hearts and our minds and our ears really tonight right down at your feet we place it. And we say, Jesus, that we don't want to hear a single word except the words from your mouth spoken into our hearts that carry eternal value. Nothing else. Nothing more, nothing less. We pray this in the name of Jesus. Help us surrender tonight our full humanity. We lay it down and we step in to the throne room. Thank you, Jesus. Open up our eyes, Lord. together. Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. Nothing else. I want to see you. Come on, let's open up our hearts and our eyes tonight. Open the lifted are you are holy. You are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see. Come on, you think it's worthy tonight. Let's sing it out. You are holy, holy, holy. Lord, you're holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Come on, let's keep on singing. As you are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. I want to see you. Yeah.
your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 to see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory, yeah. Pour out your power and love as we sing.
Let's sing it one last time together. You are holy, holy.
Come on, let's sing it out. Holy, holy, holy. Lord, you're holy, holy, holy.
We want to see you. Oh, Lord, we want to see you. We want to see you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We're going to raise a hallelujah in this place. I'll raise a hallelujah. In the presence of my enemies, I'll raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I'll raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. Raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes to fight for me. I'm going to sing in the middle of a storm. Louder and louder. You're gonna hear my praises roar. Up from the ashes, hope will
melody. Sing a little louder. Hey.
Longer slaves to fear and sin. For you have set us free, and there's no other reason except you, Jesus. And may every thought that is holding us captive in this place tonight, that is telling us that we cannot step into the grace of God, may it flee right now in the power and the name of Jesus Christ, the one that has come to set us free. You are allowed to step into His grace tonight. You are allowed to. It doesn't matter where you come from. How can I say this? Because I know who my God is. And I know what He's done in my life. And I know the brokenness He's dug me out from. And He still is doing that, and He's going to continue doing that. And I want to call you guys tonight into that same grace and that same mercy. Don't miss it out tonight. And over this weekend, we no longer have to fear anything except our God. And His burden is light, and His burden is easy. So step in tonight. Don't miss out. Don't miss out. You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. Oh, yes, we are. You've called us from the start, Jesus. From my mother's womb, You have chosen me. Lord has called my name. I've been born again to Your family. Yes. Your blood flows through my veins. Yes. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child. For I am a child.
Our minds, we lay down our everything. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee. Blessed Savior, I surrender. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee. Savior, I
I surrender it all tonight. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all, I surrender all, I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all to thee, my blessed. All to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender. All to thee, all to thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender.
Yes, Lord, we just want to thank you, Father, that today we can surrender it all. You have paid the price, the ultimate price. And Father, in this time, we just want to declare you are our God and we are your sons. Oh, hallelujah. We are so grateful, Lord. Brothers, while we are in this atmosphere, why don't you just say thank you? Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that I can be called your son. I can be called your son. Praise the name of our Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Oh, what an amazing time. In this open skies. That Angus would have said, this is the church with the nicest building. This is the best building ever. Amen. Ah, hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Sit a bietjie, man. Midpoint worship. Thank you. Hallelujah. Let's give them a great hand. Let's give Jesus a greater hand. Let's make a joyful noise unto the Lord, for he is good. Hallelujah. Now, let me tell you, I was asked to introduce this gentleman, and he forwarded me his CV. And when I got that CV, I want to promise you, this is not the type of CV you want to send to nobody. Now, this brother made sure that when I read this CV, that I need to understand, man, he's not okay anywhere. Mm-mm. But I want to tell you, he's more than okay. Because he's Oki Furi, and I want to introduce you to our brother. Please, Oki, if you can come to the front. Get onto the stage. If I can get a couple of brothers to bring this beautiful. Bring it for us. Not yet. Can we put his. He wants to say something. Ons is te na by mekaar, Okie.
Ja, my ma.
So, Okie, welkom. Welkom, welkom in
Jesus' way. Come on, I didn't give you lemon juice at the door. Good evening.
Enjoy him.
Amen, amen. Jesus is King. I found a brand new Bible verse. I think the angels put it in there just for me. And it's in Hebrews 11, verse 1. Now, faith is. I'm going to take you on a journey tonight. And what I might say might offend some of you, but you will know at the end of this night that I'm in love with Christ. There's no doubt in my mind that He's a living God. Right? I want to tell you what happens when fathers are not fathers, and when you don't have a role model to fill those shoes. How quickly life can absorb you. I know a man that is an attorney by profession. He's not an alcoholic, but right next to the lawyer's office, there's a bar. So every day when he's finished, he goes downstairs and he has one beer with the barman. He gets home, his wife is upset with him, he gives her a miss. And this carries on for a long while. One beer became two beers, and that's okay, because it's rugby. But every night when he gets home, he gets insulted. And he starts having a relationship with the barman as a best friend. One night he went home. He gave his wife a miss, went and got in the shower, and when he walked out, his four-year-old son was wearing his shoes. And the Holy Spirit convicted him so much by saying, what are you leaving behind for your child to live in? What is the message that you're sending to your child? How is he going to cope in life when the ultimate hero that he has, the first hero, is an absent dad, is a father that struggles to be present. There's a ministry called being present that means so much more than all the words we can say as men of faith, really. See what will happen with you. The enemy will come so quickly and convince you that you're worthless. Because in the beginning, God said, I will bring an enmity between your seed and her seed. And you will eat dust. So if the enemy can make you feel like dust, he'll consume you. But it's a lie. How many of you has gone home and people talk about you? And it hurts because you still have feelings. You're still in the world. You still are going to go through this thing. You've got to get up in the morning and show faith, especially if you're in the gospel. I tell you what, this is the hardest walk you'll ever do in your life. We make it look easy, but it ain't. So I want to ask the fathers here tonight, are you present for your child? Because if you're not, Jesus is going to change that tonight. He's going to change it this weekend. I have enough faith for you. I'm sorry if I'm not ashamed about the gospel. I really don't. I don't care if it's a squatter camp. I don't care if it's 10,000 people. I've got an audience of one. I only have to please one. But I have enough faith for you tonight for sons to be healed, for fathers to be healed, because they had fathers that wasn't healed. It ends tonight. It ends this weekend. Amen? Hallelujah. No, I'm so privileged and humbled to be here all the way from the United States of Heidelberg. I'm Oki Furi. I'm married to a woman. Born a woman. Not changed, no extra parts. Born a woman. I'm the world's best grandfather. I've got 5 grandkids. They think I'm amazing. Ask them, they'll tell you I'm the best. Amen. Jesus is King. I grew up very poor. All right, so I'm going to take you on this journey. When you get upset, sit down. You'll be okay. I'll take you through it. All right? I'm not going to mention names. I'm not going to make people famous. I'm just going to talk about my life. Is that okay? All right. So if anybody watch anything on YouTube, I've never placed anything on YouTube. I know there's a lot of things of me on YouTube. Good. If God can use it, great. I really don't care about that. Amen? We grew up in Krugersdorp. We were the Furies of Furi Street. Cross the road with the Botma brothers, boxers. Jimmy Abbott lived in number 19. So everybody boxed or wrestled. That's what you did. Now, the Oaks would panel each other at the Rudaport Hotel or the Florida Lake Hotel. My mom was a nurse. They'll come home in the morning, and my mom will patch them up. So we grew up in a culture of violence. A father beating a mother into a pulp. A mother that sleeps around. A mother that's alcoholic. Father's alcoholic. I grew up as a culture. It wasn't sin. It's what they do. That was their coping mechanism, because we didn't have Jesus. And because we were poor, we were picked on. I was really big kids, man. Listen, guys, you don't understand. I was born 2 weeks premature. My mom couldn't keep me in. How the world wants to do it, I don't know. It's just not going to work. I was allergic to my mom's milk because she was an alcoholic. So I grew up on condensed milk and water. I'm big. My mother's maiden surname is Breed. I'm here. Amen. It's always better on the big screen. Jesus. My mom used to get my clothes from the orphanages or from the church, or somebody will donate clothes because I had to wear big clothes. I weighed 84 and standard 4. My nickname in school was Jellyfish. And because I wore somebody's clothes, kids are rude. They'll call me a thief. Hey, you're a thief. Oh, well, give me your shoes and your belt and your back. I'm going to take it now. I was too lazy to play marbles. I'll take the whole packet. Just give it. Huh? I don't have time for that. So I was an amazing bully at school, really. I was way bigger than my classmates. I figured out they scared of me. Then I started figuring out, listen, I hate being poor. I refuse to be poor. My mom worked at an old age home. So I started selling head lice at school. I'll give you 2 head lice for 20 cents. You'll show the teacher your head. They'll give you 2 weeks off. You'll give my lice back. I refuse to be poor. Huh? I hustle, man. I'm in it for the money. Not this. My dad started privatized from my mother and he got himself a new family. And I hated my father. I really, really hated him, actually for no other reason than him leaving me and taking another man's kids and raising them. So my father had this one child that used to get hidings every day by the principal because I used to steal people's lunches. So I used to steal their marbles. I was a good thief. I stole copper in the 70s. Right? But because my father married this new woman, I inherited 4 brothers that walked and pushed up to the water. Really, they could do nothing wrong in my father's eyes. If they play cricket, they're the captain. If they play rugby, they're captain. You know those guys because I'm not the only one that hated them in school. You know that one. I had 4 of those. So I went with my mom to Mandini. It's on the south coast of Natal. Is my mic still on? Okay. Am I good? Can you hear me? Something shifted somewhere. Okay, as long as you can hear me. My mom was a nurse, but she used to really, really drink a lot. And because she had no control over me and I had no father, I started seeing that my mom's going through 2 or 3 men a week. Sometimes I wouldn't even get the stepdaddy's name. He'll be through there and gone. So I started acting out. I started acting out against everything that my mother and father stood for because they weren't examples. Yet nobody took the time to speak Jesus to me. No one. Yeah, I was a bully. Yeah, I was a thief. Yeah, I was orphaned by my dad and by my mom. Before I was 8 years old, my father dropped me at the orphanage twice. Before I was 6, my mom dropped me at the orphanage twice. Before I was 7, I shot my sister and burned the house down. I'm twisted. I'm that one. Right? So you're not going to freak me out with nonsense. I'm really a product of a horrible childhood. If somebody just took the time when I was so young to tell me about Jesus. But they refused. They never brought Jesus near me. I went to an English high school. And I started doing more nonsense there. My mom came to repentance on Yando Dits. It's an audio cassette tape. There was 12 in a series. I hope he's still alive. I don't know if he's still alive. But my mom had tape number 11. And she came to the Lord, and we went to a church. And my mom fell in love with a married dominie. So my mom and this dominie is having an affair. And he's married, but he's with my mom. So Sunday morning, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Sunday night, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Wednesday night, hallelujah, praise the Lord. But during the week, he'll beat my mom into hospital and rape her repeatedly. That's what Jesus did. That's my mindset. The age of 13 and a half, that man beat my mother up, beat me up, and raped me. I was raped by a dominie. I hated Jesus. Oh, there's not a hate. I've listened to people speaking about hate, but I endorsed it. I started to learn to fight. I joined many, many fight clubs. I became the youngest Kinesiko fighter in South Africa. I got Springbok colors in 3 different disciplines. I wanted to beat you up. I wanted to hurt you. Because I never wanted anybody to get that close to me and hurt me so intimately. Because let me tell you, there is not a soap in this world that can wash you of the hands that you are supposed to trust. That smell never leaves you. How can you be violated as a child? Who are you going to talk to? I've got no dad. I can't talk to my mom. So what do? I become a rebel. Standard 8, they asked me nicely to leave school. Other people got expelled. They asked me nicely. Please don't come back. Okay. I turned 16 on the streets in Durban. My lightning fast mindset, look, this is apartheid. You need your matric. So I forged my signatures. I wrote in at entered the Natal Technicon to do my N3. I sweat a lot. Don't worry about it. It's holy water. So what happened is, I'm going to Technicon in the mornings. I found myself a job at the Marahani Hotel on North Beach. It's a Southern Sun resort. I got paid R2 a shift as a waiter plus tips. 1984, it was a lot of money. Are we going to swap?
Yeah. Is it water? Okay, we got it. Can you hear me now? Amen. Oh, hallelujah. I've got a new version. Whoop, whoop. Whoop, whoop. Jesus. So I'm working in this hotel, and I'm going to Fight Club, and then I go to Technicon, and I'm working as a waiter. I'm actually trying to change my life. And then the head chef's son was in a Fight Club with me, and he approached me one morning and said, listen, one of the chefs didn't make it to work. Don't you want to just make sandwiches and salads for room service? And I asked him politely, how much are you going to pay me? Because it's not a waiter's job. So he said, I'll give you R4 a shift plus tips. Awesome. Right. You got it? You're going to take it off? Don't drop the pants, please. Amen. Jesus. We can have fun in the gospel. We can have fun. We're good. So I did this waiter thing now, and I'm making sandwiches for the room service. But on the 30th floor of this hotel was a nightclub with the name of Raffles. And I had to take food up to this nightclub. So when the lift opened, there were four guys fighting. Two rugby players from the Blue Bulls and two bouncers. I didn't know it was bouncers and Blue Bull rugby players. I didn't know. I knew there were four people in the way from me getting paid. So I beat all four of them up. The nightclub manager liked me so much, he made me the head bouncer. R45 a night. Woo! Stupid money. 16 years old telling under 18s they can't come in. That's me. That $45 stayed in my pocket. I didn't spend that money. I worked with the waiters because that time, the biggest denominational note was a R20. So when the gentleman brought their girls to the club, when they paid the tab, they opened the wallet so you can see there's a lot of money in it. What they don't notice is that the waiter also sees that. And the waiter will come tell me, this oak is loaded. All right. I'll wait for you to go to the bathroom. I'll knock you out so quickly and rob you, you'll come complain to me that you got robbed. And I'll walk through the club. I said, this oak. Just show me this oak, man. Oh, sorry, boss, man. These things happen. Here's a 3 pass for next week, boss. Right. So one night I'm jumping on an oak's head. And the Indian fellow walked up to me. I said, hey, I like the way you fight, boy. He says, yeah, boss, I come from a class. I'm not a boy. Ah. He says, look, I like how you fight. I said, yeah, so? He says, I'll give you R100 for every person you beat up. I said, boss, see, I'm beating 15 oaks up a night here for $45. You want to give me R100 for each one? Yep. How many people can we beat up? He said, as many as you can. What do you do? See, I asked about the money first. I refuse to be poor. So he said, I'm a gangster. I said, what's that? Man, my, whoo, what? You're going to take me as family? You're going to pay me for what I like to do anyway? Yep. I mean, that R100 became R1,000, that 1,000 became 2,000 a day very quickly. And so the underworld will take you because the world don't want you. And I got inducted. And then they told me I was going to pick up my number. And I had to choose some crimes that I could commit to get that stripes. 2 months before I turned 17, I murdered my first person. I went and killed a pastor that raped me. I didn't feel better. I didn't have release. I just got addicted. I got so addicted to that feeling of having that power over a man's life. I got sentenced. I was sent to Baltimore for 4 years. I'm one of 31 prisoners that was removed at that time for violence. So how twisted and violent must you be to be removed out of a violent prison? As they're traveling with a bus with me, I'm on this bus. 5 prisons didn't want me. Now, how sick must you be that prisons don't want you? If I ended up in Leeukop, I pulled my time. I learned to become a super criminal in jail. I learned from the best how to cut coke, how to cut back the heroin, where to get it, how to get gold, how to get diamonds. I learned how to do hijackings. I learned everything in jail. Nobody took the time to speak Jesus. No one. I smoked out 2 Bibles in prison. I like Proverbs the best because I could read at least 3 verses before the Zohar was live. And I'll mock Christians because the oak that had the bed next to me was a pastor that killed his wife on a Sunday morning. So that's what Jesus does. He beats up women, he rapes little boys, and kills women. This is my mindset because nobody's talking, they're not speaking Jesus to me. They're speaking about somebody that is so unreachable, so unobtainable, which is such a lie. Because the real Jesus is coming for the sinners. He didn't come for the saints. He came for me. I'm that one. Jesus is King. When I came out, I got inducted in, there's 3 major gangs in South Africa. I got inducted by SANI into the Young Americans, 26,000 members. I became the youngest warlord in the country. I ruled by fear. At the height of my criminal empire, I did 140,000 rand a day. And yet I was broke every day. By 10 o'clock, I'll rob somebody to buy cigarettes. Because through my life, all the history and all the violence and everything that you put in this hole, that this heart is just empty. There's something missing. You miss it. You know you're missing something, but what is it? Because I didn't understand why I'm so empty. I've got this money, I've got this power, I've got all these things that's in the world. But yet I woke up empty. Nobody wanted to talk Jesus. When I was sitting in Portsmouth, now I don't know if there's gentlemen here tonight to salute. If you've been inside, I did enough time for all of you. But they have a pea soup. I promise you, if we had the recipe for that soup, we wouldn't have had COVID. You can melt cars with that soup. I'm having this fraud soup. The oak next to me is eating a lamb chop curry. Yeah, boss, how do you get this chow? I'm having this pea soup. He says, because I'm a Muslim. What's that? You mean if I go 5 times on my knees a day, look east and pray to a God that hasn't got a living son, I can have that food? I'm in. I join for the chow. It was easier for me to do that than to believe in Jesus. It was easier for me to believe all those lies. Because they accepted me. When Christianity didn't want me, the Muslims took me. When the world didn't want me, the criminal empire took me. And man, was I a good soldier. I'm top of my game. My boss loved me. So I generated enough cash for everybody. I got so addicted to pornography, I started manufacturing porn. I put 10,000 movies a day into the market. I got so addicted to prostitutes, I had 81 working 2 shifts a day for me. Every prostitute will pay me 600 rand a day to work for me because I'm taking the heat. I will sell your body 25 times a day minimum. If I don't, I'm going to hurt you because I'm addicted. I'm addicted to violence. I'm addicted to collecting guns. I'm addicted to killing people. I'm addicted to do hijackings. I'm addicted. Because that gives me a better rush than to serve Jesus. Because nobody came to speak Jesus. Like, could one just come and say, hey man, you know what, there's a better way. I had a son out of wedlock. Bouncers tipped me off. They said, your ex-wife is actually my first wife. She was a beautiful woman. She was a Mr. SA contestant. My current wife is also a model. My daughters are models. I like good-looking women. I had this son, 4 years old, never saw him, but he knew it was mine. And the bouncers tipped me off. They said, she's in a nightclub at the ladies' night. So I rushed to get her there. She raced away from me into oncoming traffic, killed herself and my son. I didn't cry. It didn't bother me. I went to Russia and I went to Malaysia to bring girls into the country. Trading in flesh. I got charged 630 cases just trading in flesh. That was just my, that's just the escort side of my life. But I fell in love with this Russian prostitute. Man, she was a powerhouse. She used to do bodybuilding. She looked the part. She saved the part. And she was awesome. I made that thing pregnant and had a beautiful baby girl by her. My baby girl was my God. I really, really worshipped the ground she walked on. There's nothing I wouldn't have done for that child. Opposition gang couldn't take me out. One morning, they kidnapped my 16-year-old daughter. And for 8 days, I had to listen how they raped my child and how they beat her. And I couldn't save her with all my power and all my money and all my connections. Couldn't save her. I got to a stage where I phoned the head of that gang and I said, I don't want her back. I will never allow you to have that power over me, man. You will never walk around and say, you raped my child. I don't want her back. So they dropped her off in 11 pieces. They chopped her up and put her in a bin like a dog. My daughter was murdered because her father's a rubbish. She did this world no harm. Nobody came to speak to me about Jesus. I wanted to die. I started drinking more. I was doing a liter a day, a case of liters on a weekend. 7,000 rands of cocaine through this nose a week. I just wanted to die. Yeah, it's not right, don't you?
Northern room. Where were you in the court?
Okay.
So after I buried my child, I wanted to kill myself. And with all my violence, I didn't have the guts to pull the trigger. So I thought I'll drink myself until everything ends. My wife, thank God, is a Catholic woman at the time when I married her. She was a Catholic woman. It's the first person I led to Christ. It was my own wife. So I didn't want her to be in that position to understand this weirdness that I'm walking in now. But she said, we need to go to church. I said, I'm not going to a Catholic church. I'm a Muslim. So we went to a very famous church in Durban. 7:45 before the first worship song hit, they walked me out of church. Not welcome. So my question is, how did you know me so personally that you can chase me out of your church? You had to do business with me. It's not like I had a billboard. How did you knew me personally? So I'm not welcome? Okay. So I started robbing the church. If they open, I'm robbing them. Every time they open their doors, I'm robbing that church. I'm banging them. I'm jumping on the pastor's head. I'm taking their cars. I carried on with that attack until the church closed down. Because thank God Jesus was never there. He never lived in that church. There was no Jesus there. You know? Bless me and the money will come. Yeah. Rub the bum, the money will come. Yeah, yeah. I know. So I started drinking more. I started doing more drugs. Because I want to die. I don't want to be in this life anymore. My wife couldn't leave me because a funeral was way cheaper than a divorce and more trustworthy. I raped my wife repeatedly. I beat my wife into hospital repeatedly. I'm not proud of it. I'm telling you how far I fell and how far God had to come to fetch me. How he left the throne room to touch me. Because nobody wanted to talk Jesus. Everybody prayed for you, but nobody spoke Jesus. They had no authority in their voices. Yeah, Christina. Yeah. So I'm sitting in my house. I'm so drunk out of my mind. The only thing that was brave enough to attack me was my own heart. I died for 90 minutes to meet Jesus. I had an out-of-body experience. I was standing looking at my body. Behind me was an abyss of nothingness. There was darkness, fear, no sound, no light. I kept on feeling I can step into it. I didn't want to. I didn't want to be here because I'm hearing my wife crying over a man that I don't even know she's talking about because I know what I did. I can hear how they're declaring the body. I can hear how my friends are making up, how they're going to cash up tomorrow, how they're splitting the gang. I can hear the cops joking about my 220-kilogram body and how the two skinny oaks are going to carry me out of my house. I'm hearing everything. I can't go anywhere. I said every Muslim prayer I had In my spirit, I was firing. It was dead words. Now, obviously, if you guys listen to me, do you think I collected Steve Hofmeyr music? No. I like Steve. All right? But I didn't collect his music. My music was twisted like me. But God in his infinite wisdom and knowledge knew I will hear this voice. Steve Hofmeyr sang a song. The song's name is The Hand Upon My Shoulder. And he speaks as David. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall desire none. David said, all I had to do, I didn't do a sinner's prayer. I didn't come in sackcloth and ashes. I didn't have a Bible. I was a Muslim killing Christians, hurting the church. Yet he came for me. The moment I said, the Lord is my shepherd, that qualified me in totality to wake me up. My wife was very happy. My friends was freaked out. My soldiers ran away because they know I heard them. I didn't know it was Jesus. I thought I got lucky. I poured a drop, lit a cigarette and party till 6 in the morning. That's the only life I knew. I woke up in the morning. My father at the time is a missionary. He phoned my wife. I haven't spoken to my father for like 18 years. I haven't spoken to my father. 18 years. Hate him. Don't want to talk to him. My father phoned my wife and said, get this guy to the evangelist. I don't know what an evangelist is. Evangelist. Dronet Anamis is the last. He's expecting a Christian in his house because my father's a Christian. I showed up. I walked into his house. His family took the kids out the house. I'm sitting listening to this man, and he's reading out of this little book, and he keeps on saying, man, this is an awesome book. Then I got to a stage, I'm thinking, this guy's not hearing me. He's screaming at me. Why are you screaming at me? Don't you know who I am? Let me tell you who I am. And the more I'm telling him, I'm releasing a lot of anger and hurt to an unknown member. He's not a member, so why am I talking about it? And he kept on reading out of this book. So I thought, okay, now I'll scope your joint. I know where that TV is going to be tonight. There's no burglar proofing, no dogs, no alarm. Nice computer. Right, team will be here later. You just pray, because you pray for my dad. He got healed. Pray for the heart. I'll do something about the weight. But you pray, and I'll do that. And man got up. And this son of God that knew his identity in Christ laid hands upon me. And he spoke Jesus into my body. And in 2 minutes, God released me of every addiction. I had no withdrawal symptoms, no little tits. I got new lungs, new liver, new voice, colored eyes. My eyes were pitch black my whole life. You can at any time look at my baby photos. I had pitch black eyes. Also, I wasn't born with this voice. I had a very weird voice. I'm driving home for this evangelist. And I'm feeling so good. I'm thinking, man, I must be dead. You can't feel this good. There's not a drug that can make you feel this good. I don't know this thing. I don't understand it. But I want more. I need more. I go to my doctor. He's a Muslim. I said, listen, boss. I think I met Jesus. But just check me out in case. So he takes his machine. He's doing my blood pressure. And this is how quickly the enemy comes to steal. The first reading, my blood pressure is 180 over 120. And my words was this, boss, your machine only reads broken people. It doesn't know what's healed. Get a new machine. He took a new machine, 120 over 80. Immediately. They made me waddle around the block because I was so fat I couldn't walk. I went back there, 120 over 80. Cholesterol normal. After wimpy breakfast. Sugar normal. I'm healed. My sugar used to average 29 with insulin on a good day. That was my norm. I got healed. And it was Jesus. So don't tell me what I must jump through denominational hoops to come for you, my Holy Ghost. My Father can do all things. Because now faith is. I'm speaking to pastors and they can't help me. So I figured out I'll have to do this myself. So I went to sit in the library and I started thinking, what famous Christians are there? I know something about Benny Hinn. I saw some programs. I took his book, Good Morning Holy Ghost. And I'm thinking, where's this Holy Ghost? He's talking about Catherine Kuhlman. I'm taking her book and I'm reading, where's this Jesus? And then they talk about Smith Wigglesworth. I'm going through all these generals of faith and I want to know, where's this Holy Ghost? When did he leave? Because I can't find it in the Bible. I can't find that he left us. And I started attacking pastors because you're talking nonsense. He can do all things. I figured out I need to be baptized. Okay, so I did. They needed a lot of salt water. I went into the sea. Came up whole. From the time I got saved to my first dead raising in front of 3,000 people in the RGS church in Nelspruit was 3 months. While I gave this testimony, the pastor decided to die of a heart attack. I thought it was rude. Wake up. Jesus is here. You can die another day. That uncle is still alive. Amen. Because we heal the sick, we raise the dead, we cleanse the lepers, we preach the gospel unashamed. He's not going anywhere. He's here for you this weekend. I'm not here because you want me. I'm here because I want to be here. I'm that good. I'm really good at what I do. Whatever's in your body that's not supposed to be there is going to go. If it's a spirit of poverty, it's going to go. If it's cancer, it's leaving now. If it's diabetes, it's going to go. You're going to know that my King is a living God. And He loves you because 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 He loves you. It does not change. No matter what the world says, He's in love with you. It's based on Him. I get to do this awesome work. I do 40 services on a good week. A bad week is city services. I love prisons. I love rehabs. I love where the enemy steals. I'm going to come. And if you tell me I can't, I'm really going to go. Okay, don't go to that rehab. They kill the pastors. No, I have to go. I want to see who's this. Yeah? This is awesome. If you go into a prison, there's a man that's got a 1,000-year sentence, and you can pray and give him Jesus, and he feels so free. I have the privilege to pray for a heroin addict that took 5 bites out of a baby because she was high. I have the privilege to pray for 4 murderers. I have the privilege to lead them to Christ. I pay a privilege to do this. I don't sacrifice. I pay a privilege. I will not take a knee to the enemy. I want to be so hot when I get to heaven, steam must come out of me. I want to come into that gaze billowing with smoke. If you're not going to use your talent, I'll use yours. God will sort it out. He knows I'm rude. Amen? So if God can do this for me, that was so lost, so twisted, and so broken, why will He not do it for you? Because I guarantee you most of you know Jesus way longer than me. I've been walking as the Son of God for 8 years. 8 years I planted 22 churches, raised 40 people from the dead. Right? 1.8 million people gave their lives to Jesus. I'm preaching the gospel in 3 war-torn countries without a gun, without a bodyguard. I'm going because Jesus needs me. I want to go because He loves me. I need to love the hell out of you. That's my mindset. Enemy is going to lose today. Amen. So gentlemen, this is my story. This is my testimony. There's way more. There's a lot of court cases still pending. God has so far helped me to beat every one of them without an advocate because I have an advocate in the throne room. I have been arrested for Jesus more in 8 years than 35 years as a criminal. In 8 years, I've been locked up 52 times preaching Jesus where they don't want me. I know my King needs me in that van or in that cell. Maybe it's the policeman. Maybe it's the judge. I'm paying a privilege. I'm here. Let's do this. Amen. All right, so if you can see I'm on fire for Jesus, yeah? I'm going to be here the whole weekend. If you want to talk to me, I'm here. Right? Because you've only listened to that part. What if I tell you there was more to my testimony? Here's the weird part, because when I want to talk about this, people run. Cops came to my house 5 months serving Jesus. And they told me they're going to kill you. I said, I know. I phoned my same pastor. I said, boss, I'm going to go back in the underworld. I need 2 guns, 10 days. I'll commit a couple of things. I'm going to fight for all your Christians because I got the guts. And they said to me, no, you can't do that. Why not? I can come back. God will forgive me. He said, no. Once you've tasted and seen, you can't. I don't understand what you're saying to me. You're telling me there's a difference between gifted and anointed? Tell me. because I can't take a Bible to a gunfight. I'm bargaining down to 8 bullets, 1 gun, half a day. There's an O I need to take out. Thank God this pastor won. He gave me word. In the morning of 7 September 2016 in the Leopold Street rank of Durban, a city of 6 million people, my own gang did a drive-by shooting, fired off 43 shots. God healed them all. I'm the only one that's testifying, and I took 15 bullets. 3 through my right arm. You can come look at the scars. I got 4 in my stomach, 5 into my chest, 2 through my right leg, kill shot in the throat. I fell in love with Jesus. I was breathing honey. As a peace beyond human understanding, because death, where is your sting? There was no pain. Death, where is your sting? I was so in love with Jesus, I'm breathing warm honey. The gudges took me up, and the taxi drivers picked me up. They took me to the doctor's room. I'm laying in a carpet. My arm was shot. Hanging down like that. I'm bleeding. I'm seeing the flesh on my shirt. I know I'm going, but it's such an awesome and amazing experience. And the first Muslim doctor that was working on my chest said, "Oh God, this is not for me." And he ran away. And the second guy was working on my stomach. And he said, "Take your finger out your throat." I had it that far in this hole. I couldn't speak. And he took it and he started wiping the blood off. And he said, "Oh God, these holes are busy closing." From the time I got shot till I was at my bike, it was 40 minutes. God raised me from the dead twice in 5 months that I can go unashamed anywhere, anytime for his son. He trusts me with his son's name on my lips. He knows I'm obedient. I was a good soldier. I know how to take a knee when authority walks in. I know how to do that. So I follow the King, and he's the King of Kings. Amen. The churches didn't want me because I'm living in a city where I was this terror. And I'm laying on a carpet one afternoon and I'm speaking to Jesus. And I said, "What are you doing with me?" He said, "Go save my kids." I said, "Lord, I'm between the prostitutes and the hobos every day. They call me Pastor Smelly because my congregants are smelly." He says, "No, I want you to go to church. My kids are lost. They're lost in the church." I said, "Lord, how?" I'm going for interview after interview. They never phone me back. And the Lord impressed on my heart, "How did you do it in the old days?" By force. And the Lord kept quiet. So I took it as a challenge. There was a big congregation in Durban. It was a conference called Walking as Sons, heavyweights of the gospel, all testifying about their miracles and the signs and wonders. I got dressed in my biker clothes with all my patches, shorts, Crocs, put my earrings in, walked to the front, took the mic out of the pastor that was preaching, told him to sit down. I told them about my Jesus. I showed them the holes. Today I'm ordained. Today I'm studied and accredited. And only Jesus gets the glory. No man. So if he did it for me, he'll do it for you. Yeah? Right. So I bless the air that you breathe in the name of Jesus. I bless this ground you're walking on in the name of Jesus. I bless your families in the name of Jesus. I bless your problems that they're going to go in the name of Jesus. I pray that your faith will not fade, that your faith will increase over this weekend, that when words land on you, you will go forth, be unashamed of Jesus, that you'll be good fathers, amazing grandfathers, that you'll be fathers to the fatherless, that you'll be people of a heart as close as David was, a man after God's heart. May it land upon you, because if Jesus can do this with me, how much more with you? You are supposed to do more than me. And I'm supposed to do more than the one that taught me. When are we going to get up, church? When? Are we really going to go into the world not wearing the armor, not being dressed by the Holy Ghost? Are you really that confident that you're going to win this battle today? Or do you get up in the morning and give him your first fruits by reading out of the Bible? Eating his word, consuming his word, and praying in the spirit, just waiting on the Father to say, "Go, my son, I'll take care of this today." I want that for you. I want to bless you with that so that you can walk and things people fainting, that you can walk into hospitals and clear halls, because it is possible. We've got thousands and thousands of testimonies. What God can do through this old killer, why not you? Who's in it? Who wants this? Who needs this? Who wants to be the change? I'm not getting everybody. You're getting lukewarm now. Come on. Are you in? Are you sold out for Christ? Who's your king? Who? He's the King of Kings. You're the king he's talking about. Pray as a king. Walk as a king. Eat as a king, man. Whatever you allow in your kingdom will be there. Whatever you disallow will not be there. Take the reins. Be a king. Be an example. Amen? I love you. I bless you. There's a prayer tent on the other side. We're going to go there and minister to people that want to come and have prayer. If there's anybody right now that feels the unction of the Holy Spirit to give your life to Jesus and just receive his heart, I don't want you to give anything. I want you to receive the Father's heart. You're more than welcome to come. There's the team leaders that will take you to the tent. If you want to do it, yeah, good. But we are here over the weekend. We're going to make our way now to the prayer tent. And you can come there and be in total confidence from your lips to God's ears. All right? Is there anybody that don't have Jesus? I can't see in the back there. All right. Welcome. We're a bunch of weirdos, but we love Jesus and we're unashamed. Welcome to the family. It's going to happen this weekend. Do you believe? Amen. Thank you, Lord, for new faith, new souls. I'm going to round it off and give it back to you, sir. Will you release me?
Thank you.
I'm going to make my way to the 310 day. If you want personal prayer, please come and see us. There's a couple of guys here that's waiting for you to escort you to the tents. Don't leave here without prayer. Don't attack me on Facebook. I'm here now. So come now. All right? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I want to invite every single person who has not made a commitment for our Lord Jesus Christ to please come to the front. Make that decision today. If you want to make a recommitment and you know that you've backslidden in this last bit, please come to the front. You're going to see this gentleman with these beautiful blue bips. They are here to help you. They are here to love you. Come on, let's welcome them. Come on. Please come to the front. Let's just envelope one another. Let us just enclose one another with the love of our God. Amen. I can see there's still men coming. Let's come. Come, guys. Come, guys. Come, guys. Come, guys. Come, guys. Hallelujah. They are still coming. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Is there still anybody? There we go. Come, young men. Let's do this for Jesus. Let's do this for Jesus. Is there anybody else? You know, God wants to do something in and through your life. It's for you to stand up and say, Lord, here I am. Here I am. Look at our brother. Welcome, my brother. Welcome, my brother. Welcome, my brother. Hallelujah. Here they come. Here they come. You know, Oki, he had nothing. He lost everything. But he gained everything. Hallelujah. Is there still anybody else? Before I pray. You're still gentlemen coming. Hallelujah. Come, brothers. Come, brothers. Can I ask all the ministry team to please come and join us here in front? I'm just going to do a prayer with you. Sorry, these lights are so bright. I need to see if there's anybody. Yeah, there's still people coming. Come. Hallelujah. Come make the decision for As for me and my house, you see, you first need to make that decision for yourself. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord and no one else. I love the way Oki said, start your first fruits and give it to the King of Kings. Hallelujah. I'm going to pray for you. And then I want to ask you, walk with these gentlemen to the ministry team. There's a beautiful ministry team tent right there. To my left. You're right. Please go and go to that area, because they're going to share with you a word. They're going to pray with you. And this is the best thing. This is the best step you could ever take. This is the best decision you could have ever made. Hallelujah. Let's pray together. Brother, can I ask that everybody stand up with us? This is such an important decision to be made. Let's not take this lightly. And let's reach out to our brothers here in front. Father God, we come to you this evening and we just want to thank you for a word. Thank you, Father God, for a word today that has had a deliberate intention to tell into your heart, into specific hearts here today, a truth. And the truth is, God is good. Our Father is good. It echoes in my mind the way Oki reminded us that he loves you, he loves you, he loves you, he loves you, he loves you. And Father, I pray for every single man who has made a decision or today to give his life to the Lord, or who has decided to recommit his life back to you, Lord. I pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that this will be the day. The 22nd of March, 2024. The day that I made my decision, I'm going to follow Christ and no one else. And I pray, Father, that you bless every single one of them. And Father, even if there is men here today who did not come to the front, I pray, Holy Spirit, break those hearts that is hardened. Break those hearts. Father, South Africa needs men. South Africa needs men who are willing to say, I love my family. And I will do anything for my family. Today, South Africa needs sons who are willing to say, Lord, I will do anything for you. Because the only thing that can change South Africa is Jesus. Nothing else. Politics has tried, Lord. Nice words, nice laws, everything has tried. But Father, we know, I know in my house, Jesus is the answer. And I stand on that. So I pray for every single man here who has made that decision, Father, that today they do not turn back. This is a 180 straight towards that beautiful cross where we have an engagement with the Lord Jesus never to turn back again. Lord, I thank you that we will see miraculous things happening here this evening in the lives of this young men and fathers, even grandfathers. I pray that in Jesus' wonderful name. And I thank you, Lord, that the work that you have started, that you will fulfill it through your Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Amen and amen. Please, ministry team, can we guide our brothers, please, to the ministry tent? Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's give the Lord a hand. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. If you need prayer anytime during this weekend, that ministry tent will always be manned. There will always be somebody there. So please, I want to hand over back to Midpoint or to JP. JP, can you give us a last little song? Thank you. And now we'll close in prayer.
Just one last time before we go out tonight, let's just surrender ourselves. This whole weekend, all our thoughts, all our ideas, let's lay it down at the feet of Jesus. We're not going to take up minutes and minutes
JP,
now.
JP, just one second for me. Brothers, this is not finished. This is not finished. We need to make a commitment. And the only way you can make a commitment tonight is by accepting Jesus Christ. Okay. After this, we're going to take you to the tent. But we're not going to let the opportunity pass now to get you into the kingdom of God. Because that's where you need to be. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Remember, last year, our theme was chosen. And we said to one another that many have been called, but few are chosen. Few are chosen. And if you have accepted the call of Jesus Christ tonight, then you need to be here. Then you need to be here. So I want to pray over these guys here, and I want you to pray with me. All right. Let's do it publicly. Okay. Right. Father God, I come to you in the name of Jesus. And Father, today, tonight, I confess my sins. And Father, I ask you to forgive me. And Father, tonight, I open up my heart to you. And I accept you as my King, as my Savior, as my Deliverer, as my Healer. Thank you, Father, that by accepting you, I understand that I am now called a child of God. And I give you all the glory for accepting a sinner like me, bringing me into the kingdom, forgiving me my sins, and never to think of them again. And today, tonight I decide to follow you, come what may. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, brothers. We love you. We sing you. Midpoint is going to sing a song for us. Thank you very much. Love you guys.
Amen. Amen. And when we're going to raise one last hallelujah, setting the tone for this weekend. Let's glorify our King together, and we're going to get a good night's rest until we get again together tomorrow morning. Amen.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemy. I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah. Heaven comes. Heaven comes to fight for me. Yeah. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm. Death is due.
shout it out one more time. Sing a little louder.
In the presence of my enemies.
Sing a little louder.
Yes, praise the Lord. Tomorrow morning, 10:05. Let's make it 10:00. Sounds better. We'll meet one another here, and we're going to have an amazing time praising the Lord. And we're going to have Zane, who's going to give us some word. We're going to break some bread tomorrow. Isn't it wonderful when we can have some communion together? We can share in the body of our Lord Jesus, who has paid the price. So, brothers, have a blessed rest. Please, just a reminder, no open fires in the areas where you stay, please. Don't make it difficult for the commandos now. And have a good rest, and I'll see you tomorrow morning at 10:00. Bless you.